myself Dr. Rajesh Kumar, Department of Zoology, SPC Government College, Ajmer. Today my topic is second messenger system, अर्थात द्वितीय संदेश वाहक तंत्र. The topic is divided into 8 points: introduction, discovery, examples, types and properties, mechanism, synthesis, general schematic of second messenger mechanism, common mechanism and second messenger in the phosphoinositol signaling pathway. Now first point is introduction. Second messenger are intracellular signaling molecules released by the cell in response to exposure to extracellular signaling molecules. That is the first messenger. Second messengers trigger physiological changes at cellular level, such as proliferation, differentiation, migration, survival, apoptosis and depolarization. They are one of the triggers of intracellular signal transduction cascades. Now, discovery of second messenger system. Scientist Earle Wilbourn Sutherland discovered second messenger, for which he won the 1971 Nobel Prizes in Physiology or Medicine. The mechanism of second messenger system were worked out in detail by Martin Rodwell and Alfred G. Gilman, who won the 1994 Nobel Prizes for second messenger system. Now, examples of second messenger system. Second messenger molecules include cyclic AMP, that is cyclic adenosine monophosphate, cyclic GMP, that is cyclic guanine monophosphate, inositol triphosphate, that is IP3, diacylglycerol, that is DGA, and calcium. The first messenger are extracellular factors, often hormones or neurotransmitters such as epinephrine, growth hormone and serotonin. An important feature of the second messenger signaling system is that second messenger may be coupled downstream to multi-cyclic kinase cascades to greatly amplify the strength of the original first messenger signals. For example, RAS GTP, that is guanosine triphosphate signals, link with the mitogen activated protein kinase, that is MAPK cascade, to amplify the allosteric activation of proliferative transcription factor such as CREB and MYC, that is MYC. Now, synthesis of second messenger system. Secondary messenger system can be synthesized and activated by enzymes. For example, the cyclase that synthesize cyclic nucleotides, or by opening of ion channels to allow influx of metal ions, such as calcium signaling. These small molecules bind and activate protein kinases, ion channels and other proteins, thus continuing the signaling cascade. Now, another point, types of second messenger system. There are three basic types of secondary messenger system molecules. First is hydrophobic molecules, second hydrophilic molecules, and third gases. First, hydrophilic molecules. Water insoluble molecules such as diacyl glycerol and phosphatidyl inositol, which are membrane associated and diffuse from the plasma membrane into the intermembrane space, where they can reach and regulate membrane associated effector proteins. Second type, that is hydrophilic molecules. Water soluble molecules such as cyclic AMP, cyclic GMP, inositol triphosphate, and calcium ion that are located within the cytosol. Third type, that is gases, nitric oxide, carbon monoxide, hydrogen sulfide, which can diffuse both through cytosol and across cell membranes. These are three types of secondary messenger molecules. Now, properties of secondary messenger molecules. These intracellular messengers have some properties in common. First is, they can be synthesized or released and broken down again in specific reactions by enzymes or ion channels. Second, calcium ion can be stored in special organelles and quickly released when needed. Third property is, their production or release and destruction can be localized, enabling the cell to limit space and time of signal activity. Next point, that is common mechanism of second messenger system. Common mechanism of second messenger system have four steps. First is, agonist activates membrane-bound receptors. Second step, G proteins is activated and produces effector. Third step, effector stimulates second messenger synthesis. And fourth step, second messenger activates intercellular processes. Next point, general schematic of second messenger mechanism. There are several different second messenger system, such as cyclic AMP system, phospho-inositol system, and arachidonic acid system. But they all are quite similar in overall mechanism, although the substances involved and overall effects can vary. In most cases, a ligand binds to a membrane-spanning receptor protein molecule. The binding of a ligament to the receptor causes a conformation change in the receptor. This conformation change can affect the activity of the receptor and result in the production of active second messenger. In the case of G protein coupled receptors, the conformation change exposes a binding site for a G protein. The G protein named for the GDP, that is guanosine diphosphate, and GTP, that is guanosine triphosphate molecules that bind to it. The G protein is bound to the inner membrane of the cell and consists of three subunits that are alpha, beta, and gamma. The G protein is also known as the transducer. When the G protein binds with the receptor, it becomes able to exchange a GTB, that is guanosine diphosphate molecule, on its alpha subunit of a GTP, that is guanosine triphosphate molecule. Once this exchange takes place, the alpha subunit of the G protein transducer breaks free from the beta and gamma subunits, all parts remaining membrane bound. The alpha subunit now free to move along the inner membrane, eventually contacts another membrane bound proteins, that is the primary effector. The primary effector then has an action which creates a signal that can diffuse within the cell. This signal is called the second messenger or secondary messenger. The secondary messenger may then activate a secondary effector whose effect depend on the particular secondary messenger system. Now, calcium ions are one type of second messenger system and are responsible for the many important physiological functions including muscle contraction, fertilization and neurotransmitter release. The ions are normally bound or stored in intracellular component such as endoplasmic reticulum and can be released during signal transduction. Similarly, cyclic AMP, that is cyclic adenosine monophosphate, another second messenger. Now, last point, second messenger in the phosphoinositol signaling pathway. IP3, that is phosphoinositol phosphate, DAG, that is diacyl glycerol, and calcium ions are second messengers in the phosphoinositol pathway. Again, IP3, DAG and calcium ions are the second messengers in the phosphoinositol pathway. The pathway begins with the binding of extracellular primary messenger such as epinephrine, acetylcholine and hormones AGT, GHRH, oxytocin and TRH to their respective receptors. Epinephrine binds to the alpha first GTPase protein coupled receptor, also known as GPCR, and acetylcholine binds to M1 and M2 GPCR, that is GTPase protein coupled receptor. Now, binding of a primary messenger to these receptors result in conformational change of the receptor. The alpha subunit, with the help of guanine nucleotide exchange factors, that is GEFS, releases GDP and binds GTP, that is guanosine diphosphate, and binds guanosine triphosphate, resulting in the dissociation of the subunit and subsequent activation. The activated alpha subunit activates phospholipase C, which hydrolyzes membrane-bound phosphatidyl inositol 4,5-bisulfate, that is PIP2, resulting in the formation of secondary messenger DAG, that is diacyl glycerol, and inositol 1,4,5-triphosphate, that is 1P3. IP3 binds to calcium pumps on endoplasmic reticulum, transporting calcium ion, another second messenger, into the cytoplasm. Calcium ion ultimately binds to many proteins and activating a cascade of enzymatic pathway. Thanks.